Yeah, seriously. It's actually not that cold. It's just very super humid. But I don't know why that camera's got condensation and this one doesn't. Hey, Oren, how's it going? It's going pretty good. Just trying to make things work here. Things are not cooperating in the workout. Should be halfway through sprints by now, but things are not functioning. I can actually stop this ride. Stop this ride and start over again. Say it works like 50% of the time, it seems. That all the sleep. Thank you. Maybe it's a sign that it doesn't want me to do this workout. Totally tracking. Like, as soon as I press play, want to do the after party. Right. Looks like it's working. Unbelievable. Let's do this. That was annoying. For some weird reason, the head unit picks up two kickers, but they're both the same ant address. And you gotta keep switching back and forth until you kind of find the right one that actually sticks. Yeah. Super weird, and it's, like I say, it works 80% of the time, and then all of a sudden, I don't know why it's picking up two, but I swap to the other one, and all the power, everything's working. It's only an hour workout. And I tried to start this at like 5 o'clock. 37 minutes of messing around. What's weird is it only has an issue with the power. Like, it'll pick up cadence, it'll pick up the heart rate, it picks up the speed, but the power itself has issues. What I should probably do in the future is sit there in the sensor pairing and don't actually try to start my workout until I've found the right power meter. The trainer is going to react to these intervals. 15 seconds. I have to move this out of the way. Okay, I'll get the next one. I'll get the next one. That one was bad. Probably. Two and a half minutes, we got this interval. We'll be right back. quiet 30 seconds about this one this time. Way better. I got it. Fixed that as well. A minute still, interval number 3. Thank you. 15 seconds. Four, three, two, one. Didn't quite hit that. Thank you. Oh, better.
Thank you. Thank you.
seems to be working. Kind of had to figure out some stuff that I needed to be in a bigger gear. Because what the head unit does, as soon as it hits a big sprint, it puts it into like a 5% incline. So it kind of disengages ERG mode. And I was in a small ring in the first couple, spinning like crazy, but it doesn't ERG you. As soon as the big sprint, the big interval happens, it turns ERG off and turns like slope mode on. I think I got it figured, which makes more sense because you don't really want it messing with your sprint, trying to auto adjust all the time. So it just makes it that like you're going up a 5% hill and you just basically sprint. But I've never done this many sprints ever before on a single ride. I can safely say the most ever 900 plus watt sprints I've ever done on a ride is probably 3. And that workout was 10. But I really, really need to work on my overall sprint, because typically I'm done. That was the last one. That was number 10. Almost the only time I ever sprint is once a week on Tuesday, coming up to the finish line and ZRL. So my form is probably horrible, like just doing repeated efforts, even if I'm not hitting, you know, the 922 watts, whatever it wanted me to hit, at least I'm getting out of the saddle and like concentrating on, you know, getting the cadence up. It seems like in ZRL, the people who get all the points are the sprinters. Ah, I signed up for that ZRL chase race tomorrow. And there's already 154 people AutoCADed into the C division. I'm really interested to try the, I'm going at the 5:20 PST time. Yeah, I'm really interested to try the AutoCAD because it's neat. Like, I'm looking on, you know, when you look on the sign up, it actually says restricted for all the other classes except for C. I don't know how hard I'm gonna go, because I gotta save some energy for Tuesday's team time trial, but it should be fun. I'm glad Zwift is kinda, you know, trying out the AutoCAD stuff a bit more. Yeah, it looks like there's 176 people for B, 38 for A, 53 for D. I think whatever class has the most people has the best chance. Because you're going to have the largest blob. Yeah, that is a lot. Well, you know what? I think with the AutoCAD system, I think you're gonna get some of the high-powered Cs that have really huge sprints AutoCADed up to the B. Because AutoCAD, you know, takes into account your 15-second, your 1 minute, your 5 minute, your 20-minute power, and bases what class you should be in on all four of those, yeah, four of those parameters. I know we have some guys in the C's who have huge sprints. They have just enough 20-minute power to stay with the lead group, but their sprint is insane. So they have crazy 5-minute and 15-second power. Like, are they really a C? You know, in season 3 of the ZRL, I was B, but I was B by 0.01 watts per kg. Like, is that really a B? You know, I was like way off the back all the time. You know, I was classified as a B, but up until that point, I'd never been top 20 in a C race ever. But I somehow jumped to the B division. Look at that. Workout over. Let's turn that off. Let's turn No, get out of the menu. Look at that. Are you kidding me? I completed the route just sitting here. Oh, really? Well, I like the AutoCAD system, or at least the theory of AutoCAD, because, I mean, the ZRL does a really good job of upgrading people and getting them in the right division, but when you do any normal, regular Zwift race, it's always filled with sandbaggers. Yeah. Is the KOM? What course is it? Oh yeah, the Magnificent Eight. Yeah, that K. The hilly KOM, that could be bad. See, that'll break the group up, because with the AutoCAD system, you're gonna get a crap ton of people with super high 5-minute power blowing up the groups going up that hill. Did it just put me on a new route? Like, I finished the route, and then it's like, hey, you should do another one? Holy moly. Wow, Peter. Scaring the crap out of everybody. How are you doing tonight? Just finished up my sprint interval workout. Doing a little cool down. I'm gonna jump off the bike in a minute. No, that's not a good idea. Definitely not. City car, the silhouette on the ocean after dark. All right, I need to get out of this. I'm messing stuff up here. I didn't want to do a ramp test, but when I'm fresh, otherwise I'll be super disappointed with the results. Meters.
Shadows in the city. I'm a stranger to myself. On these streets, I'm someone else. Shadows in the city. Like a demon in the dark.
There we go. 32. Going downhill.
Shadows in the city. I'm a stranger to myself.
Oh, fans holding now. Alright, well, thank you guys for stopping by. I am done for the evening. I will be back tomorrow for a little bit of ZRL chase race.